Hi guys, by request here, Call Me the Breeze. I've got a bunch of requests for this song, which I'm going to cover today. And it is it's a timely video because this week's been a very exciting week. And I have received in the mail my Street Survivors movie that everyone has worked hard to get this movie out for quite a while, as many of you know. If you order this from Amazon, you get the physical copy, which is pretty cool. You get a Blu-ray, a DVD, and you get the soundtrack, movie soundtrack. So this is pretty cool. I gotta get the band to autograph this for me. Anyway, this has been a long time coming. We're pretty excited about that. Our buddy Pat Travers did Call Me the Breeze, actually a version of Call Me the Breeze, which is on this movie. You're not going to hear any Lynyrd Skynyrd music on this movie for legal reasons, but this is a J.J. Cale song, and Pat did his version of the song, which is great. We do this song live in our live show most of the time. It's a fun song to do. But regarding the movie, very happy this is finally out. It came out this week. So order you a copy from Amazon. We'll put a link in the description of this video. So today we're going to check out the original recording of Lynyrd Skynyrd's Call Me the Breeze by J.J. Cale and see what we could pick out of that. All right, so I think I use my Hughes guitars on a couple of videos and it didn't work out so well. They're great guitars, however, me and my customizing, I said, I don't put anything on the, I like the full black neck. Well, that's not really great for instructing you guys and showing you guys stuff. So I'm gonna use the SG on this. Let's listen to the intro, Call Me the Breeze, and see what we got. All right, you know how it goes. So I've got a phase shifter on my signal here, and I'm using a hybrid style picking in my pick. A. So let's hear how that goes with that and check it out. That lick keeps going. Through the verse. That little thing from the five, from the D. Just chromatic down to B and then back to the A. Hear how that goes. Let me give you that little solo in the beginning. Alright, we're taking that on the upper octave here. That's it. Something like that. This is the other guitar without the phase. All right, let's learn some feels. There's a feel. It's kind of cool. Over the years, I mean, I've played this song since it came out, you know, originally. And then you had the live version come out, One More from the Road version. So you had, you know, gains involved, and you had all these different licks. It's been a great song, learning the licks over the years. And, you know, and then we play it, and we kind of adopt our own way of playing this stuff and our own licks, but I like to go back and kind of revisit these and kind of revive some of the little nuances of some of this stuff. So, and plus, actually, Jerry does the solo work on this song. I do the fills on the last verse, but that's all I do. And I probably do more of a Steve Gaines type Strat thing than anything else on the end. I don't play it exactly like this original version, but. Anyway, that's the story. Let's just kind of go through and we'll take some of these fills. This first fill in the second verse, take some of the high end off of that. Let's see. It's kind of a slide down from a. I believe that's about how it goes. Let's listen. Yeah, that's like a. Then it goes to the four, to the D. Let's see. Well, And then the next was. That's a cool little lick. Yeah. All right. Now we're going to the Gary's solo. So this solo starts here. Some of the gain out. So this is an A7. Just listen to that. Let's take it that far. Off the A7. Let's hear that. Let's see. That's a cool little thing there. I'm just basically slurring it. I mean, see, I'm only hitting my pick a couple of times. Then we do that. So just play that along with it. That's a cool little Let's hear that. So, let's see here. That's a cool little. Like you can play this in a couple different places. I've done it in both places. It's just wherever my brain goes, where my fingers go. Same notes. Billy's piano solo. I used to do this. I was actually playing keyboard synthesizer in this band, so I would jump on. I would do like play Billy's solo on my guitar. It was really weird. But sometimes you can get some cool licks out of a piano solo. So. Anyway, there's some cool stuff in here that does translate to guitar. Anyway, here comes a horn line that we do with octave guitars. All right, let's talk about that. Does the horn line, Jerry and I will do octave guitars there. Jerry will grab the high one. And the horn stabs that we do together, it's a 9 chord. So so the voicing on the 9, on the D, on the 5, mm-hmm. say a, like a, you know, the regular nines, like. So that's it. And then it goes to the E. Check it out. You'll hear what it sounds like. That's a cool little signature thing. That's like a little roll. That's like a to the five. Anyway, that's that leads to the last two notes, which is B flat to A. Those are sevens. There's your seven. Anyway, Call Me the Breeze. There's some high points for you. Thanks for watching my videos. Really appreciate it. Please hit subscribe. Go buy the movie or order it on Amazon. They'll ship it right to your door. And hope you enjoy that. Hope you enjoy the soundtrack. We'll see you next time. Thanks.